We're thrilled to have the opportunity today to recognize and honor three very deserving alumni this afternoon. Thrilled that you could join us for that. As you all know, alumni play a critical and, I would tell you, a central role in the function of any college or any university. Not only do they help us in the recruitment of students and faculty, they provide much-needed financial support, but I would tell you, most importantly, they represent the potential and the possibilities of higher education and the importance of higher education. Higher education is very much about identifying and unlocking a student's unique potential, realizing possibilities and establishing a positive trajectory for our students, helping shape lives that make a positive difference in the world. Alumni help make tangible and visible for current students their future possibilities and the impact that education can make in varied ways and in varied contexts. Today's recipients come from a diverse and unique set of backgrounds, with each having made significant and enduring contributions, and I would argue contributions that have changed their communities and changed the lives of the individuals around.
Jonas Lubermudroff, Huffner, Mayfield, Walter P. Reed, J.D. Williams, Robert Hinckley may not be names recognized by students today, but they gave me so much. Because the purpose, as Malcolm Forbes says, of an education is to replace an empty mind with an open one. And my learning from them gave me that opportunity. I was an undergraduate from the University of Utah. I was about 21 years old, and I was interviewing master's graduates from Harvard and Yale and other schools. And one day I said, "Mr. Collins, I am amazed that I have this opportunity and I'm meeting all these young students who have graduated with masters in such prestigious Ivy League schools." And he looked at me and he said, "Leigh, that takes a straw. I'm kind of fond of universities from states, and I have to tell you, you had a good education that you got from that university." And I think he was absolutely right. So thank you so much for this great honor. I love this university. I'm delighted to be included with such wonderful gentlemen, Dean, all of you in this room whose shoulders I have stood on, whose assistance you have given to me, and even for those I don't know, thank you so much. It means the world to me.
I graduated a long time ago, shortly after the end of World War II. It had been over a few years. FDR was dead, and Harry Truman had vanquished Tom Dewey for president, and I had a newly minted degree in political science. After service briefly in the Navy at the end of World War II, I came home even more determined to be part of the political process. Even before I could vote, I participated in what we then called mass meetings, we now call caucus meetings. In those days, you had to be 21 to vote. That's a long time ago. I headed up the campus of Democrats and eventually secretary of Salt Lake County Democratic Party and later a delegate to the National Convention which nominated Jack Kennedy. And yes, in those days there was more than one party in Utah. Quite frankly, it works better when there are two. That in part is what my undergraduate degree did for me. I really thank those who taught me to read with understanding, to write hopefully with clarity, to think with consistency, and to speak to be understood. Now there is something more, particularly in public service. And by the way, did you notice that everybody here today graduated from political science? something more important, particularly in public service, especially in public service. There's an overlay. There is moral content, doing the right thing for the right reason. Means and ends need to harmonize. And we all need to remember that we leave our moral fingerprints on everything we touch.
I think debate coaches had a lot to do with my interest. Coming off the farm in Star Valley and moving down to Utah, I'd never seen a newspaper or listened to the news. And in high school, I went out for debate and started reading the papers and listening to the news and reading Time magazine. And I even got a debate scholarship along with basketball to Weber State. And that's where I really felt like I came under the tutelage of some great people, Leland Monson in debate and Rod Julander in political science. But after my mission, I came down to the university. And I felt like I wanted to major in political science. It just was amazing how my life changed because of these political associations and relationships. Now, I've learned that you don't have to run for political office to do good. There's a lot of ways that you can help. And I've enjoyed so much the association I've had with so many of you in the community, helping on so many projects. It's a great thing to graduate in political science from the University of Utah because you have wonderful colleagues and some of the greatest friends you'll ever have. And my son Christian graduated, my son Andrew, my daughter Kimberly, they've all followed in this, and they appreciate this college like I do.